Magic in Bay St. Louis, Mississippi. And the championship will be coming up in just a few minutes. Tony Tubbs given a chance to rest. He will not go to the craps tables. Maybe later after the night of boxing.
And it comes down to what some people thought it might, a veteran, one of the group of veterans here against one of the younger fighters. They might not have thought it would be these two specifically, though certainly Tubbs was considered one of the top favorites. And of the younger guys, I don't know that Dan Dancuda was. And in truth, of his last performance against Larry Donald, wasn't one of the young guys that was most highly thought of here. You might have gotten better money on his first opponent, a Derek Roddy or a Craig Peterson or one of those guys. But Dan Dancuda showed heart, he showed power, and he got here.
And I think that will be the interesting matchup here. We've seen Dancuda come out real strong early, and certainly expect him to do that again. And how will Tony Tubbs respond? Will he be tired? Will he be able to hold off the on-charging and powerful Dan Dancuda? So we are minutes away from the championship of this Super Fights tournament, which has seen Bert Cooper go out in the first round, Bone Crusher Smith go out in the semifinals. But Tony Tubbs, a one-time WBA champion, has advanced to the championship round and the chance for the big prize money. Tyrell Biggs suffering the defeat, the unanimous decision victory to Tony Tubbs. Dan Dancuda is outside the dressing room. You can see him in the distance, getting ready, and Tony Tubbs is with Bert Sugar right now. Bert?
Tony, how tired are you?
Man, I'm getting old.
You're getting old. You ready for this final coming up?
I got to be ready, man.
All right, I'm going to leave you alone, but what are you going to do now to counteract the fact that you're giving away some age, you're giving away some time?
I got to use smarts, ring smarts.
All right, you heard it here, and I'm going to leave this poor gentleman alone so that he can get his 6 minutes, is what they're hollering, time to rest. We're here with Tony Tubbs and trying to get out.
Okay,
back
Bert.
To Sam Al at ringside.
Thanks, Bert. Tony Tubbs rests. Al is with the CEO of Casino Magic, Marlon Torgerson. Al, take it away.
Thank you, Sam. Marlon, this is a little different than the events you've been holding here, though you are rapidly becoming, some say, the capital of boxing, certainly here in the South. This event has a different feel to it.
Hey, this is great. This is something different. It was offered to us, and I wanted to do it. It's fun. It's a fun event.
It is. It's been kind of funky, and you guys kind of came to the rescue a little bit of some of the promotional difficulties.
Well, we overcame that. We're here tonight. We're doing a great job, and we're going to have a good fight.
Boxing has figured prominently in your marketing scheme. Why so, and was that something, as soon as you opened this, that you thought this is going to be something that's going to help lure people?
Well, it's a sporting event. We're very sports-minded. We love the action. We love the fun. We know that people that like to go to the casinos usually like boxing, so we wanted to put together an ongoing tradition for Casino Magic, so we're going to do this wherever we go with one of our Casino Magics.
Can you see championship matches being held, or a lot of championship matches? Would you like to see that?
Oh, we'd love it. We're in the process of building our big arena here. It's going to seat about 6,000 people when it's all done, indoor air conditioned, so we can get out of the tent. But when that's all done, we're going to go after one of those big events.
Surprisingly, you mentioned his tent. I remember when we first came down here for a show. This is not a bad venue for boxing, though.
It's great, really. We air condition the thing, and we heat it. Good lights. We got a lot of room, so it works out great for us.
All right. Listen, thank you very much. Congratulations on a good show.
Thank you very much.
Marlon Torgerson, who runs the Casino Magic here. Let's go to Sam.
Okay, Al. And take a look at the top of the evening, the odds Bert Sugar put together. Daniel Dancuda, he rated as 500-1. Well, the odds have shortened. He is in the final against Tony Tubbs. Right now, one of the great former champions of the world, Larry Holmes, has joined Bert Sugar. Bert, take it away.
I'm here with Larry Holmes. Larry, this is your second home, not Holmes, here at Casino Magic. What do you think about this format?
I think it's a good format. Give these guys opportunity to come out and show and make some money. You know, if they don't get a chance to fight for the title, at least they make it some money in the world. Opportunity to see them, and the possibility is wide open now since there's so many champions out there and these fighters don't want to fight nobody, so maybe these guys got a chance to get in that line.
Did you ever consider coming into this tournament?
I considered it months and months ago, but my advisors and whatnot thought that this would not be a tournament that Larry Holmes should get in because I'm shooting for a title shot. I'm looking for a Lennox Lewis, and I know I won't be able to get a Holyfield again, so I'm looking for big and better things. Any one of these guys out there in the top 10 will give me a shot so I can show that I'm still capable of doing what I can do. But, hey, this kind of thing is great for these guys, but it's not great for me.
How about Riddick Bowe? Would you fight Riddick Bowe?
Fast, quick, and in a hurry.
Okay.
But I don't think they want to fight me because one of the things I don't do, and maybe somebody say I keep walking around with a black cloud over my head. Maybe I do, but I don't like these guys to get offer me something, and what they really offer me is nothing, just so I can say no. But, you know, we're willing to fight anybody out there that's available and ready to fight. I've been saying that for months. I fought 5 times this year already. Even though these fighters didn't have names or whatever, but I've been trying to stay busy because these top contenders, we say, do not want to give me that opportunity.
One quick question. You're 44, Tubbs is 35. What do you think about his ability to snap back after a very tiring fight and fight the final in minutes from now?
Well, Tony is a pro and he's only 3 rounds. You know, Tony just got one problem that he don't like to stay in top condition. But Tony's a good boxer. Tony's been out there fighting. The guy he's fighting is strong, determined, and he wants to show everybody that, you know, he's going to take this $1 million check home tonight. I wish him good luck.
And we're going to go back now to Al and Sam at ringside. This was Bert with Larry Holmes.
Thanks, Bert, and thanks to Larry Holmes. There is Daniel Danguda, the young man from Romania, under the tutelage of Jesse Reed, his trainer, and heading into the ring for a chance at $1 million. Daniel Danguda already is guaranteed in this fight 50,000 cash, 50,000 deferred, and if he can win, $1 million.
Potentially $1 million,
yeah.
Yes. At least 100 and, what, 70,000, is it?
That's right. Definitely 170,000 if he wins. They get the big bag out, they stuff it with the bills, and Daniel Danguda would be a very, very happy young man.
This 22-year-old's having his biggest payday, period, anyway, with only 6 professional fights.
Larry Holmes trying to stir the drums up in Bay St. Louis, where he's had a few fights before.
It has been a venue that's been very kind to Larry Holmes.
Yeah. Still waiting for Tony Tubbs.
Now, we thought earlier about this earlier today about what would happen if a fighter was stalling. And truthfully, it's kind of what Tony Tubbs is doing right now. And how long will they give him?
Well, in the background, Tony Tubbs, who's just coming off the win over Tyrell Biggs, the unanimous decision victory. We're waiting for him to emerge from the locker room area as he rests up. Earlier, he faced Willie Jackson in the first round and picked up bonus money with a first-round knockout over 24-year-old Willie Jackson. A late fill-in was Jackson. Then in the second round, it was Tony Tubbs and Jose Ribalta. And though Tubbs stumbled there, he landed some big shots early against Ribalta.
Yeah, he showed that he had the power against Ribalta that was necessary in what was a kind of a awkward match. But Tony Tubbs got it done, and then against Tyrell Biggs, more than got it done. Hurt Tyrell on a couple of occasions and just pretty much outboxed him. And he's making Daniel Danguda cool his heels in the ring right now. And the question is, how long will they let him go before they disqualify him?
Well, I think he'll go right up to the last second. And as soon as they say, Tony, come out now or you're disqualified, and then Tony will be coming out. Looks like he's getting ready to emerge right now. Bert Sugar is there checking it out.
Everything okay, Tony? All right. Tony Tubbs is emerging from the locker room right now.
Well, he took every last second. He'll be going into the ring against Daniel Dancuda, the young man. In his first round opponent was Derek Roddy from Kansas City. And he just banged away at Roddy.
And that big right hand, one of the best weapons for Dancuda, although normally he's even better with the hook. And he was just too much for Roddy.
Overpowered him, and the referee stepped in and stopped the fight. And then he got a walkover in the second round when Craig Peterson from Australia could not compete and into the semifinals against Bone Crusher Smith. And though Bone Crusher had a good first round, it was Dancuda coming up big.
He stood in, he slugged with Bone Crusher, took advantage of the fact that the 40-year-old Bone Crusher Smith just got tired.
Landed some big left hooks.